弟兄姐妹平安，很高兴哈，我们又可以回到教会来聚会，来崇拜我们的神啊！因为时间的关系，我们现在要开始。那当然，一开始的时候，我们还是要来欢迎新朋友哈。有没有第一次来的？哦，我看第一次是没有啦，第二次的就有。第二次我的同学啊，他也是我们第四个礼拜的讲员，哈，注入新生命。年轻人啊，这是我们英文部牧师，对，好，然后我们很高兴看到余生姐回到我们当中哈，是，好，还有我们的文成弟兄也回到我们当中，感谢主哈，真的很感谢神啊，还有我们今天也有一个来宾，就是我们的约翰牧师的师母，是。大家可能都蛮认识他的啦齁。哦，还有一位来宾我看到了。刘彩霞传道。你们应该认得他吧。有些人应该认得他齁。很开心他今天来到我们当中齁。真的很开心今天大家都可以齐聚在这里。那我们就做一个开始的祷告，我们就进入敬拜齁。是的，爱我们的父神，我们向你献上极大的感恩，你是配得尊崇与赞美。主啊，我们要将今天的崇拜全然交托在你的圣手当中，更把我们的约翰牧师还有达妮啊交在你的手中，求主圣灵与他们同在啊，恩膏他们的口，让他们传讲的让我们都能够得到帮助。主，谢谢你，我们要将以下时间全然交托仰望，这样祷告，奉主耶稣基督宝贵的圣名，阿门。好，我们现在站立，来用诗歌敬拜我们的主。 弟兄姐妹请坐。好，我们今天是由我们英文部的约翰牧师来为我们传讲信息，然后由党妮来做翻译。我们请约翰牧师跟党妮。
哈利路亚，
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 哈利路亚。
弟兄
姐妹
，brothers and sisters，
你怎么才不读呢？弟兄姐妹平安，
平安。
到现在我还没有勇气，以华语来跟你们分享哦，真的对不起。 天还是要靠主你来帮我翻译，谢谢。
感谢主。
我们先来读经文。
我们先来读经文。
Okay.
今天的经文呢，是从路加福音第二章第四节。可能你们大家可以，如果有手机还是有圣经的，请打开路加福音第二章第四节。好，夜色从加利利的拿撒勒城上犹太去，到了大卫的城，名叫伯利恒，因他本是大卫一族一家人。
Let us pray.
让我们一起低头祷告。
Father, this morning we come expecting you to speak to us.
神啊，今天早上我们来到你的面前，渴慕听到你对我们说话。
The Holy Spirit open our hearts to let us listen to you.
圣灵啊，你来敞开我们的心，让我们的心能够听到你的声音。
So when our hearts receive your word, it will change us.
好让听着你的话的时候，我们的心会被改变。
In Jesus' name we pray.
我们奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen. How many of you have heard of the story of a little Dutch boy who saved his country?
你们当中呢，有几个人曾经听过一个荷兰的小孩曾经救了一个他们的国家？请举手。
With a little finger, he saved his country. How many of you have heard the story?
他用了一根小指头来拯救了他整个国家。你们有听过这个故事吗？几个人有听过？
You have never heard of the story?
你们没听过吗？
It's a little story where the boy knew that was a, you know, in Holland, the water is above the land.
Yeah, 因为这个小孩知道呢，你知道在荷兰吗？荷兰是比海平线低的一个国家，所以水平线是比一般的陆地高的。
So the country actually built up walls to stop the water from coming in.
所以这个国家呢，有建了很多的堵的墙来堵住堵住任何的洪水。
So what happened was that the boy one day was walking by and he saw there was a leak of water coming out of the wall.
所以有一天，这个小男孩呢，经过这一堵墙呢，就看到有个缝，有个洞，那个你。水就从那里流进来了。
So what he did was he put his little finger in and he stopped the water from coming in.
所以他就用他的一个小指头堵住那个洞口。
And the story says that he saved his country from flooding.
那个故事呢，告诉我们呢，他就这样的把洪灾所避免了。
But that is only a fictional story.
可是呢，这个是一个虚构的故事。
But my daughter had a very powerful finger.
我的女儿呢，也有一只很有能力的小指头。
When she was a baby and she couldn't speak.
当她还是婴儿的时候，还没有办法讲话的时候。
And when we carry her, my wife and I carry her.
当我跟我太太抱着她的时候呢。
And she will point to finger,
她会指着一个方向，
Then we will go there.
那我们就乖乖的跟着走去。
And then after that, she,
等她过后就，
And then we will go there.
那我们就跟着去了。
How many of you with children, your baby was like that?
你们当中的妈妈有几个孩子是这样的呢
？Okay，babies have got very powerful fingers.
婴儿呢有很强大的一只手指。
But it is true that small things are powerful.
可是呢，就以这个小小的东西呢，能够发出一种很大的能量。
Little screws hold a whole airplane together.
那小螺丝钉呢，就把。一个体积比它大很几千倍、几万倍的飞机呢，所固定了。
The chairs you're sitting on is held together by little screws.
我们的当中在坐的椅子呢，也是以它小螺丝钉来巩固的。
And if not, it will all fall apart.
要不然呢，整张椅子就会支离破碎了，不能够用。
A small virus that we cannot see spoil the whole.2020 for us.
一个小小肉眼看不到的微生物呢，把我们整个世界呢弄得天翻地覆。
When I was very young, I heard of this chorus of this Christmas carol, "O Little Town of Bethlehem."
我小时候呢有听过一首圣诞节的歌， 他的名字歌名叫做伯利恒的一个小镇。
I don't know whether there's a Chinese version.
我不知道华文有没有叫一个版本。
没有啊。
O little town of Bethlehem.
Cannot sing.
你是来的？哦，是啊 ，cannot sing. Sorry.
OK.
哎呀，对不起，不能给我唱，太不由自主了。
But the song says little town of Bethlehem.
那歌里呢，特别的提到那个小的小镇。伯利恒小镇，伯利恒。
Bethlehem is so small that nobody knew about it during Jesus' time or understood about it during Jesus' time until the Bible tells us Jesus was born in that little town.
伯利恒是这么的一个不起眼的小镇，没有人知道它的存在，一直到圣经告诉我们耶稣在伯利恒诞生。
And it is in Matthew and in the Gospel of Luke that we know about this little town of Bethlehem because Jesus was born there.
我们是从马太福音跟路加福音里面知道这个小镇的存在。
At that point in time, it was a small town. It was a humble town. It was a city town of about 1,000 people.
当时呢，这个地方是这么的小，这么的不起眼，有近于死沉沉的一个小镇，大概只有1000多个人，住在那里。
Yeah,
当时的人们呢，都是以种植跟畜牧为生。
How many of you have heard of Ulu Jo?
你们有几个人听过乌鲁鸠这个地方吗
？Anyone?
任何人吗？
你们
可能曾经听说过麻波或者巴杜巴虾。
But Ulu Jo is also a small town in Johor near Gulai.
Yeah, Ulu Jo 呢是一个离开古莱新山古莱很靠近的一个小镇。
So Bethlehem was like Ulu Jo then. Nobody knew about it.
伯利恒呢就像 Ulu Jo， 其实当时就没有人知道，没有人认识他。
But it was not always like this.
可是呢，它其实不是这样的一个光景的，不是常常是这样的光景。
In the Old Testament times, Bethlehem was a very crowded place, was a rich place. There were many people there.
在旧约里呢，伯利恒是一个很富有的城市，是很多人来人往的一个地方。
Because it was along a trade route.
因为它是沿着一个贸易路线，它是在中间，在路上。
So it was a surprise when the prophet Micah told the people a little bit of news.
所以呢，很出乎意料之外的呢，就是米迦先知呢，告诉了我们一点关于伯利恒这个小镇。
Micah told the people in Micah 5, chapter 5, verse 2, that this is what God said.
先知米迦在米迦书第五章第二节，神这么说。
But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, you are only a small village among the people of Judah. Yet a ruler of Israel will come from you on my appointment.
伯利恒啊，以法他呀，在你犹大诸城中微小，将来必有一位从你那里出来，在以色列中为我做掌权的。这是根据神初始所定的。
He was saying that Bethlehem, you are going to be so small amongst all the cities in the town, yet there is going to be a king coming from your little town.
是的，伯利恒，你就会是那么小的一个城市，比起其他城市来说，可是呢，在你当中会出现一名国王。
And the truth is, by the time Jesus was born.Bethlehem had become a small, quiet, insignificant town.
在耶稣诞生的时候呢，伯利恒已经成为了一个死沉沉的小镇。
Many people have found another easier road to go and to buy and sell things from country to country, city to city.
可能人们已经找到另外一条通路，很平坦的，很容易通行的，从城市跟从城市之间 沟通。
And we will not know why it happened, but we know that by that time when Jesus was born, we found it in the Bible.
我们不知道为什么会是这样的一个情况呢？可是呢，我们只知道的从圣经来告诉我们的时候呢，伯利恒就是这样的一个平静死城的小城。
Now Jesus was born in this small little town because God had a big idea.
那现在耶稣呢，在这个小镇里诞生呢，因为神有一个很伟大的工作要做。
This is God's idea, God's principle.
这是神的想法，也是神做事情的一种原则。
I want us to listen carefully.
我要大家小心的、清楚、小心的来听一听，仔细听一听。
God chooses that which is small, unimportant, insignificant in man's eyes, so that he can do his purpose for all.
神拣选那些人们眼中看为微不足道的、不重要的，来成就神自己的旨意跟计划。
God has great purposes.
神有很大的计划。
But he always used the small, the weak to do things.
他常常都用小的、软弱的人去成就他的事。
In the Old Testament, he chose Israel to be his people.
在旧约里，他拣选了以色列成为他的子民。
Israel was not the strongest people.
以色列呢，不是一个很强大的族群。
Israel wasn't the most number of people.
也不是人数最多的那一群人。
In fact, in Deuteronomy 7:7, God said, "I choose you because you are the smallest number of people, and you are the weakest."
反而呢，在申命记7:7，神说：“我选选你，因为你的人数是那么的渺小。”
We know of King David that God has chosen.
我们认识大卫王神所拣选的仆人。
But if you read in 1 Samuel chapter 16,
如果当我们读到撒母耳记上16的时候呢
？On the day that prophet Samuel came to look for the king that God has asked him to anoint, he went to Jesse's house, David's father's house.
当神要撒母耳去到耶西的家里去见那个未来的王的时候呢？撒母耳来到了耶西的家。
So what did Jesse do? Jesse lined up all his boys, you know, all his sons. Some of them big size, some of them clever, and he lined all of them up.
那耶西他怎么做呢？他就把所有的孩子们叫来，那这些孩子呢，都是高猛的，都是聪明的，那他们就排成一排。
Except for David.
就没有叫到大卫。
Because David was a little bit smaller size.
大卫呢，就是个子小小的。
And you realize that the Psalms are many of the Psalms are written by David.
你们有发觉到很多的诗篇都是大卫所写的吗
？So when he was young, looking after the sheep, David was already singing songs.
当大卫在牧羊的时候呢，他已经开始唱歌了。
If you are a father who is looking to your sons to be strong,
那如果你是一爸爸，希望孩子长得很威猛、很强大的话。
And then you see your son every day play guitar, sing song.
那你每天看着你的孩子拿着吉他唱着歌。
You think you would choose him?
你觉得你会选他吗
？You'll be so disappointed.
你可能会很失望哦。
Because you say what can he do?
你会说他能够做些什么呢
？But God said no. David is my king.
但是神说不，大卫就是我的王。
Because he knows how to worship me.
因为他懂得怎么敬拜耶和华。
In 1 Corinthians 1:27-29, Paul writes this.
在哥林多前书1:27-29，保罗这么写。
I'm going to read it in English and then I'll ask Sister Tammy to read it in Chinese.
我将会以英语读，那过后我会以华语来。
But God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. God chose the lowly things of this world and the despised things and the things which are not strong to nullify the things which are, so that no one may boast before Him.
第27，神却拣选了世上一错的。叫有智慧的羞愧，又拣选世上软弱的，叫那强壮的羞愧。第28，神也拣选了世上卑贱的， 被人厌恶的，以及那无有的，为要废掉那有的。29节，使一切有血气的，在神面前一个也不能自夸。
This is the lesson, my brothers and sisters.
这是一个我们要学习的功课，弟兄姐妹们。
That God chooses the small and the weak and the insignificant, that so that no one can boast before Him.
神拣选那渺小、软弱和看不起的、不起眼的，为着使人无可在神面前自夸。
So that no one can say, "I did it. Look at me."
啊，这样呢，没有人呢就能够说，来看我，我成就了，是我成就的。
But all of us must say, "God did it." But
我们大家都会宣告说，是神成就了。我们看着他，是他所成就的，不是我们所成就的。
This morning, as I stand here and I look at all of us here,
当现在我站在这里看着大家的时候
，I sense that there are a lot of us here who feel very small.
我能够感受到我们当中。有些人会感觉自己是很渺小的。
And when I say small or that you feel small, you are telling you are saying that you don't feel that you're useful in life.
你觉得小呢？是因为你觉得在你的生命当中呢，你没有什么的作为。
Some of us say that you're too young.
有些人，我们当中有些人会说我们还小，年轻。
And when sometimes as a pastor, I say, "Can you help me to this young person?" The young person will say, "No, I'm too young."
Yeah, 有很多时候呢，我对着一个年轻人说呢，你可以帮我做这件事情吗？他们都会说，哦，不用弄，不不不，我还小。
Many of us feel that we're too old. Back here, many of us feel that we're too old.
我们这里很多人觉得自己已经很老了。
And the same thing, I ask, can you help me? And I'm too old, I'm too old.
Yeah, 一样的，当我问大家，可以帮我做这件事情的时候吗？大家都说，哦 no, 我已经太老了，太老了。我们当中有些觉得自己没有受很好的教育，受过很好的教育。
Some of us feel that financially we have very little to offer.
有很多，我们当中也有很多觉得我们在经济上是无法做任何奉献的。
Some of us feel that we have made mistakes and there's nothing else we can do.
我们可能当中也有许多人觉得自己做了很多错事，也没有办法做些什么。
I want to share.Four or five persons' lives to you.
现在我要跟你分享五个人的生命故事。
The first one is about two elderly sisters.
第一个呢是两位老姐妹。
These two elderly sisters live in a place near Scotland.
他们呢住在一个地方是靠近苏格兰。
They were born in the 1800s.
他们是在1800年代出生的。
So by the 1900s, they were pretty old.
在1900年代的时候呢，他们已经相当老了。
And by the 1940s, they were in their 80s.
在1940年的时候呢，他们已经差不多八十几岁了。
They were Christian ladies.
他们是基督徒。
You see up there, Christine and Peggy.
你在这个照片里面，我们有看到克里斯丁跟佩吉。
In the middle is a pastor, their pastor.
中间那位呢是他们的牧者。
Now the thing about it is that they were Christian, but they couldn't go to church.
他们呢是基督徒呢，可是他们不能够上教会。
Because Peggy was blind.
因为佩吉是瞎了眼的。
And Christine was arthritis and her body was bent over.
克里斯丁呢，他有关节炎，说他的整只脚已经弯曲了。
But they had a message from God in their hearts.
可是呢，神在他们心中给了他们一个信息。
They stayed in their house, a little house, and prayed for the land.
他们在他们那丑陋小小的家里呢，为他们的国家祷告。
They were praying for revival.
他们为他国家的复兴在祷告。
And the Lord, in His grace, brought revival to the land, to this place called Hebrides, in 1949 to 1952.
神以他的恩典呢，在1949年到1950几年的时候，复兴来到了他们的地方，叫做克布迪里群岛。
can you do in your old age?
在你的这个黄金岁月里面，你能够做些什么呢？
What can you do when you are blind?
你能够在你瞎眼的时候，你能够做些什么呢？
What can you do when you are bent?
当你已经身体弯曲了，你能够做些什么呢？
The brothers and sisters, the most powerful thing you can do is to pray for the land.
兄弟姐妹们，最大的能力就是在这个情况下，我们能够为我们的国家、我们的地方祷告。
The most useful thing is to pray for the land.
最有用的方式就是为国家、为我们这块土地祷告。
Isaiah Cheng.
以赛亚·成。
Singapore boy.
啊，新加坡人。
37 years old today.
今年他37岁。
When he was 25 in university in Australia, one day.He had an encounter with God.
在他在澳大利亚读书的时候，在他差不多25岁的时候，他跟神有一个很深的经历。
And God says, begin to work with old people.
神告诉他开始跟老人家一起服事。
I mean, a young person, too young to work with old people.
一个年轻人太年轻了吧，去帮助老人家。
Although I've said this, we have our own story too.
虽然我这么讲，我们也有我们的年轻人明峰弟兄。
But what happened was that this brother called Isaiah Cheng, he went and started this thing called empowered aging.
在神的带领下呢，这个年轻的弟兄呢，他创办了一个帮助老人家走入美好黄金事业的团体。
Someone asked him, "Why are you a young man working with?"
有些人问他，你为什么一个年轻人想要去帮助老人家呢？
But Isaiah says every time he works with these old people, he shares the gospel with them.
Isaiah 说呢，他每一次服侍这些老人的时候呢，他就有机会把福音传给他们。
Benny CTO.
师徒 Benny.
Some of us, how many of you have seen Benny CTO before?
你们当中有没有人见过他呢？
Benny, I know Benny. Benny was an ex-prisoner.
我认识 Benny. Benny 是一个在监狱里面我认识的弟兄。
He was an ex, and he was an ex-convict.
他是曾经是一个囚犯 ，Yeah.
But when he came out, when he met God in the prison, God spoke to him that not only am I going to stop you from being a bad person, but I'm going to use you to help others.
在监狱里呢，神跟他说话。神说：“我不只会把你的过往去修复了，我还会大大的去使用你。”
And he says, "What can I do? I am not very well educated."
我能够做什么呢？我教育也不受的教育也不多。
And so God says, "You go and start something that you like, cooking."
啊，的确，开始一个你很喜欢做的一件事情，就是烹饪。
And the story to cut the story short today, he is the owner of 18 chefs.
今天呢，他就是18主厨餐厅的创始人。
And he brings in his people, the ones who serves you, young people who are in trouble, and ex-convicts.
如果你去到那个餐厅呢？服侍你的人是那些在曾经在困境里的年轻人，或者曾经犯错犯罪的人。
He says that this is a place where they can work without people judging them, saying that oh you are like that or you are like that.
他说，在这个环境下呢，没有人可以批判他们，没有异议的。他们你们曾经做过些什么错的，没有人会异议。
He says that it is a place where if you see a person with a dragon and a tiger here is prepared to serve you, so that and a place where nobody says you are so terrible.
当你在那个餐厅的时候，你会看到很多弟兄服侍你的时候呢，他们身上的浑身都是很多龙啦、狮子啦这一类。可是，在当中呢，是没有人会去批判他们的。
Because it is a place where you can bring the people back.
因为那是一个帮助他们能够顺利重返社会的一个地方。
Benny says that that place is not only for Christians.
Benny 说那个地方不只是给基督徒。
But he prays and hopes that all of them after crossing 18 chefs will become Christians. Hallelujah.
他希望呢，当他这些非基督徒进来的时候，当他们离开的时候，他们将会成为基督徒。
Robin Burke.
彭弟兄
，two times cancer，
两度的癌病患者
，once it was nose cancer，
第一次是鼻癌
，and then when the medication from the nose cancer led to leukemia，
那过后呢就从鼻癌呢延伸到血癌 ，yeah， 血癌
，but as he went through it， he learned how a person who has cancer。Will go through that journey.
因为他是一个病患者，所以他知道整个过程 是如何的辛苦。
He understood how his wife, as a caregiver, was challenged by looking after him.
他也能够很清楚的知道他的太太是他当时的照顾者，他的感受是如何的，是多么的痛苦的。
He understood what it means financially to be very tight.
他也了解在经济上会面对许多的困难。
So he knows that a lot of cancer patients and their families, what they go through.
所以他亲身的经历了这些，他也知道在所有的病患者的家中可能经历的一些事情。
So Brother Robin started a cancer support ministry.
所以他开始了一个支持癌症病患者和家人的事工。
And he helps a lot of cancer patients to go through their journey.
他呢就来到他们的身边，一起跟他们经历这一段他们生命中的这一段。
Again, Robin, for his ministry, it is not only for Christians.
所以他的事工呢，也不只是给基督徒而已。
And like many CPO, he hopes that everyone who he works with will end up to know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior.
他也希望每一个跟他能够服侍的人呢，当他们一起走过的时候，他们会经历神的爱，成为耶稣基督的孩子。
My friends, I can go on with many stories.
弟兄姐妹，我还有很多很多故事可以跟你们分享。
But just this for the old, the weak, the uneducated, the convict, the young, the sick, God will use you if you are able to say yes, I am willing.
这几个例子呢？软弱的、没有受教育的、年轻的，只要大家能够让神来帮助我们，我们神都会跟我们一起度过，也能够使用我们。
God doesn't look at how small or how weak or how little you are or how little you have.
神呢不会看你有多小、你有多少，或者你有多少的知识。
God is looking for hearts.
神正在寻找一颗愿意为他自己的国度去服侍被使用的心。
Others will see you as useless.
人家可能会认为你没有什么可用之处。
But if you are willing,
但是如果你愿意的话，
God will make you useful for his kingdom and also to bless others.
神会使用你在他国度里，而且去祝福其他人。
And when you let God do that, you are worshiping every day with your life.
如果你这样做呢，你其实每天都用你的生命来敬拜神。
In another 5 days will be Christmas.
再过五天就是圣诞节了。
I want you to think of Bethlehem.
我要你思考思想伯利恒。
The small insignificant town that God used to bring the son.
那个不起眼、微不足道的小镇，但神在这小镇上让他的独生子跟把他的拯救带入人间。
His salvation, his son into this world, my friends. If you are willing, God is waiting for you to be like Bethlehem.
神的独生子诞生了，来拯救了我们。如果你愿意的话，你成为今天的伯利恒。他能够用你把他救恩的故事去跟人家传扬。
Jesus is just waiting for you to say, "I'm not old, but I can."
耶稣在等待着我们说，我不老，我可以。
I'm not young, but I can.
我不年轻，我年轻，可是我可以。
I am poor, but I can.
我可能不是很富足，可是我可以。
I am not well, but Lord, I can.
我可能有很多病痛，可是我可以。
I want to close with this story, and it is not in the script.
我会以这个故事来做结束。
I have known Serena for husband and wife Serena and Peter for many, many years.
我认识 Serena 跟 Peter 这位夫妇已经很久了。
Serena is the daughter of our English service Mary Dio.
她是我们英文部Mary Dio 姐妹的女儿。
Serena contracted what is called motor neuron disease, a disease that makes her muscles weak.
OK,Serena 呢得了一种病，就是她的肢体，她的动，她的行动哦，是已经会每天在衰退的。
And at 40 years old, she was already in the wheelchair.
在她40岁的时候，她已经坐轮椅了。
And then slowly she can't swallow.
慢慢的她就不能够吞东西。
And then she can't speak properly.
她不能够好好的讲话。
3 years ago,
三年前
we were told that Serena wouldn't make it.
医生说她不久了。
Because her blood count dropped suddenly.
因为她的红血球指数一直在掉。
So the only thing that we can do here in Singapore is to pray.
所以在新加坡我们只能够做的事情就是祷告。
And we pray for her.
所以我们持续的祷告。
And then her blood count went up.
那她的血球指数就升高了。提升了。
But I told Lillian, my wife, and say that you know the following year we must be in New Zealand because the Lord has a word for her.
那我告诉我的太太Lillian说，明年我们一定要去见他们一面，因为神有一些话要对他们说。
So I think that was in 2018, right?
所以那年是2018年。
We went to New Zealand to pray with Serena.
我们到了纽西兰，就是做这一件事情，去跟他一起祷告。
She was, you know, she's in a situation. She's better, but she still is in the wheelchair. Every time she eats, she coughs. And every time she speaks, she coughs halfway. She will none of her sentence is full.
所以当时呢，她是坐在轮椅上的。她每一次吃东西、说话，她都会咳嗽。那他所说的话是断断续续的。
And I know that a person like her in the wheelchair, she can't move, her body is like this. She's feeding very slowly, her whole body tremors. I know it is very frustrating.
对，当他每次坐着呢，身体是歪一边的，可是在自己喂东西、吃东西的时候呢，他每一个动作呢都是在颤抖的，所以他其实是很辛苦。
And she didn't tell me this, but I sense.Thought about being useful.
所以呢，他没有告诉我这个想法，可是我的里面有这样的一个感受，就是说他觉得他好像没有用了。
So that evening together, my children was with us, and then we prayed over Serena.
所以当那个晚上，我跟太太还有孩子们围着他为他祷告。
And I prayed that her voice, her throat would clear.
我祷告说，神说来把他的喉咙敞开，他能够很容易的吃东西，很容易的说话，他会很顺畅的去呼吸。
And then we all went to sleep.
那过后我们大家就睡上床了。
This morning at breakfast,
第二天早上在吃早餐的时候呢，
Suddenly, my children came to me and said, "Dad, see Auntie Serena."
突然间，我的孩子们跑过来说，爸爸，来看看Auntie Serena.
She was eating without choking.
她呢，很顺畅的在吃着东西。
She was talking the whole sentence.
她说话呢，是一个完整的句子。
She was breathing without having to breathe too hard.
她很能够很顺畅的就呼吸。
And suddenly, the Lord's word from me to her was this.
突然间，神有一句话在我的心里要告诉他。
The word is Serena. You are a person who is still sick. You can. It looks that unless there is a miracle, you will never be well again forever.
Serena, 你看起来就是一个很病重的人， 除非有一个神迹的出现，你就会是这样的一个样子。
But God is saying to you, it is from your wheelchair. Pray for those who are sick.
可是神要告诉你，在你的轮椅上呢，你要为其他病患者祷告。
Because it is from your point of being sick, you understand how others who are sick, how they feel and how they are living their lives.
因为呢，你在你的这个岗位呢，你很清楚的知道其他病患者的感受跟经历。突然间，他觉得他很有用了。
Recently, this year, Serena was not well again.
今年呢 ，Serena 又病又身体又不好了。
And the church, those of us who come together for prayer meeting, we be praying, pressing in praying for her.
我们教会呢，我们常常聚集在一起为她祷告。
And by God's grace, she has recovered again.
感谢赞美主，他的身体又好起来
了。
我相信呢，他为其他患者祷告的工作还没有结束。因为呢，他知道我们在这边为他的病痛祷告，所以他也知道只要通过祷告，其他病患者也能够在神的医治下恢复起来。神是不看在你是多渺小或者是多软弱的，因为他要在他的国度里面使用你，因为对他来说你是有用的。让我们一起低头祷告。
Can we just be quiet for a short while?
那我们来安静下来。
Today, if any one of us here feels small,
如果我们当中今天有谁感受到自己是渺小的
？You feel that you are too old or too young.
你觉得你太老或者太年轻
？Too little education.Too little finances.
没有受过什么教育，经济也不很好。
Any one of us here feel that I've done bad things that, you know, I don't know whether God is able to forgive me.
我们当中可能有些曾经做过错事、错误的事情，也不知道神会不会赦免我。
If you are the last one, God forgives you, because
你是，如果是你最后那个，就是那个做错事，不知道神会不会，赦免你的。神已经差派了他的儿子耶稣基督为你钉十字在十字架，你的罪已经被赦免了。
This morning, come to God and ask God for forgiveness.
今天早上我们来到他的面前。叫神来赦免我们的罪。
And you can see how marvelous He's going to work in your lives. He's not going to look at how old or young or whatever condition you are. God is going to use you mightily for His kingdom's work.
无论你在什么样的情况、什么样的身份，神在他的国度里要继续的使用你。
So Lord, be with us.
神啊，与我们同在。
Bless us.
赐恩给我们，把我们的眼目专注在伯利恒，让我们成为今日的伯利恒。奉耶稣基督的名，阿门。
啊，弟兄姐妹，请站立，我们以一首诗歌来回应今天的信息。
敬拜的声音发出 新歌，我们神要做新事，旧的事都已经过去，在基督里一切都要更新，新的眼界，新的意象，新的故事，新的方向，
全地都要渴望呼喊荣耀的主，我愿天涯敞开，恩膏倾倒下来，神国度的荣耀彰显，全地都要渴望呼喊荣耀的主，我愿你来，圣灵引领看见新的意象，要做新的事在我们中
深处，神的儿女要唱一首新歌，我们神要做新事，旧的事都已经过去，在基督里一切都要更新，眼前新的意象，新的故事，新的方向，全地都要渴望呼喊荣耀的主，我愿你来，天要唱
是的啊，我们是神的孩子，我们从来都不渺小，只要我们有信心，也愿意被神来使用。 接下来我们要有一些家事的报告，本来应该是在前面啦，可是因为人没有来得很齐，所以我就把它放到后面好了，希望大家都可以听到。好了，我们来看第一片。这个刚刚应该要讲，就好，没关系，我们现在再提醒一下，就崇拜的时候呢，我们需要全程戴着口罩啊，到目前为止都是要这样做的。然后诗歌敬拜的时候呢，我们只能轻声的哼唱，不可以唱得太大声啊。明年呢，我们就会有现场的敬拜团带领。好，明年是感恩哈，然后但是会众还是一样不可以大声的唱，只能哼唱。然后我们在散会后呢，要有秩序的离开。然后能够使用楼梯的弟兄姐妹呢，我们就请走楼梯。我们把电梯留给这个年长者或者是行动不方便的弟兄姐妹来使用。那注意，电梯一次只能承载五个人。好，接下来我们荒坡崇拜暂时呢还是会在早上十点，因为以前是十点半，那目前的主日崇拜还是需要要上网登记拿票哦，所以如果你们需要我协助的话可以跟我说，好，我就会帮你们拿票。好，接下来今年的圣诞节25日呢，我们有圣诞崇拜，请弟兄姐妹呢回来一起和我们庆贺及纪念主耶稣基督的诞生。好，我们说我们都生日都要庆祝嘛，哈啊，孩子生日啊，我生日啊，啊，谁生日啊，都要庆祝。那主耶稣基督的生日呢，我们更是要来庆贺。然后教会呢，有一点点的精美的小礼物要赠送给弟兄姐妹，在圣诞节那一天啊，我们会有准备。这个礼物是我专程从台湾订过来的啊，是飞过来的哈、啊，精美小礼物啦，哈哈，小礼物啊，不要期望它就是个小礼物，但是是真的很精美啊，而且还是特地从台湾空运过来的哈、啊。所以，但是呢，星期五的聚会呢，还是一样要上网登记啊，所以呢，会上网的人就自己上网，真的不会啊，跟我讲，我会帮你们上网的哦，哈、啊。好，那个再接下来。因为呢，其实我刚到这个教会，你们也知道，所以呢，在前面哦，对，哦，是我没有加下去哦。那个，这个是我们的一个祷告会，今年的星期五午间呢，我们有个中英的一个联合祷告会，都是在 room 上面的。那刚刚过的这个星期五呢，已经是今年的最后一次了，所以今年就告了一段落。那明年呢，我们会改为在每个月的第二跟第四个星期五的晚上八点一样有这样的祷告会，那一样是采取线上的祷告聚会。好，请弟兄姐妹要记得参与鼓励你们参与祷告会。好，来，再接下来。我刚刚就是要讲这一片，因为那一片是我加进去。好，因为我刚来这个教会没多久，来的时候又刚好是 COVID-19, 然后很多东西我都不是很清楚。那当然现在呢，我需要重整，就是说我们保持过往，就是招待主一样是由慧明姐妹来负责。那么这个影音呢系统还是由我们的明峰执事。啊，敬拜团呢，因为有一些的改变，所以我们会交由当妮姐妹来负责。那么弟兄姐妹，如果你们对这些服事有负担呢，就根据您个人的恩赐，然后跟我们以上的这些负责的同工来接洽。好，希望你们可以献上你们的并不渺小的自我。好，那我们接下来明年呢，我想挑战大家一件事，也挑战我自己，不是因为我好像是一个传道人就一定是可以一年读完一本圣经，不要这样子看我 ,OK? 我也跟你们一样不是那么的完美 ,OK? 所以呢，除了挑战我自己也是挑战你们，我们明年呢要挑战一年读完一本圣经，我会给大家这样子的一个指引，到时候我会印给大家就是在下个礼拜天可能就会发给大家，然后大家就根据上面的我们同步进行。好，有时候呢我们可能彼此找一个伴就会遇到的时候就会问Stacy 你读了吗这样子 OK, 那但你被问的时候请你不要不开心啦，我们只是在彼此监督，不是在彼此就是彼此鼓励，不是彼此监督 OK, 就是大家心里要有一个很正面的一个积极的一个想法，不要觉得说你今天，那当然你如果做不到也没有关系，不要太过于给自己这样的一个压力，大家尽力来完成这样子的一个挑战就可以了。 好，那最后我们还是一样要讲，如果你今天有现金的奉献呢，可以使用我们的信封袋哈，在离开的时候就投入我们招待员的这个袋子里面。好，愿上帝也赐福大家。那我们最后要请大家站立，我们要请我们的约翰牧师来为大家祝福。好，请大家站立。
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace, now and forever. Amen.
好，我们平安散会。